yes, and you know it tickles me. If it rains on Sunday, folks stay in the bed. But if it's raining on Monday, they still get up and go to work. But you ought to remember the one who gave you your job. It was Jesus, the one who woke you up early this morning. I feel like preaching right now. I'm reminded of over 2,000 years ago. God called a huddle up in heaven. And he said, I need somebody who can run this ball. I need somebody who can get a score on the board. I've been trying to send everybody, but it looks like they're not able to score a touchdown. I sent Adam and Eve, but they disobeyed me, and I had to put them out of the game. I sent Noah, but he broke the rules and got drunk. Had to put him out of the game. I sent the three Hebrew boys to the backfield, Hatshack, Meshack, and Abednego. But they couldn't do it. They couldn't run the ball. Then I saw somebody standing on the sideline, and he kept on jumping, and he kept on hollering. It's like fire shut up in my bones. His name was Jeremiah. But I told Jeremiah, you may not score, and I can't use a crybaby on the team. And by that time, the cheerleaders had come out onto the field. And I heard the cheerleaders say, Jesus, Jesus, he's our man. If he can't do it, nobody can. I heard what God said. God said, I'm going to change the rules. God says, I'm going to get into the game myself. God said, I'll be the quarterback. And I heard what the Holy Ghost said. The Holy Ghost said, you're not leaving me, but I'm going to. I'm going to be the center. And when they got into the huddle, they began to call the sick. The Bible said that the Lord called the huddle. And when they got into the huddle, the quarterback said, we're going to run the ball on 66. Jesus, God told Jesus, I want you to go down, and I want you to go out, and I'm going to throw you the pass. And when they came out of the huddle, the lineup began, and I heard what God said when he began to call the number. 39 represents the book of the Old Testament. 27 is the book of the New Testament. And all of them equal 66. He backed back. And I can see his child out on the field saying, here I am, Daddy. Here I am. Give me a shot. And Jesus threw the ball. And Jesus went running. Climber across 42 in the rain. Climber through all kinds of chaos. Kept on running. Hallelujah. They tried to stop him at the pool of Bethesda, but he kept on running. They tried to stop him. Hallelujah. When he was going backwards and forward, but Jesus kept on running. They tackled him in the Garden of Gethsemane. Hallelujah. But Jesus, he kept on running. He kept on running.
Somewhere lollygagging and shucking and jabbing and skinning and grinning and trying to
why you need to be where you're supposed to be. Own your house. There are other folk that you have to deal with before you get into the game. Whenever we go to a sporting event, we got to give the ticket to somebody who leads us to our seat. And if they're not there, you will have folk all over the place. Thank God for the ushers. Matter of fact, even before you get in here, you got somebody directing you on how to park. Thank God for the guard. We all play a part. When you leave here today, somebody got to come in here and clean up your mess.
Amen.
Thank God for the custodian. We all have a job to do. And the ball is in our hands. And the Lord wants to know, can he trust you? Can he trust you with your ball? Can he trust the quarterback? Preach, teach, and live according to the word of God and feed the shepherd. Can he trust? Can he trust the sinner? Be over the finances of the church. Can he trust the guards to be on their posts, going out visiting the sick and helping and being an assistant to the quarterback? Can he trust the tackles to live a certain kind of way so that, that the Bible tells us that the aged women should be there to show the younger women the way? Can God trust you? Can he trust the cheerleaders to continue to sing songs of Zion? Can he trust us? Because reality of it is, he was able to trust his child. His child scored. The coach, the Holy Ghost, is on their post. But what about you? Super Soul Sunday. Can the Lord trust you with the ball? Can he trust you with the ball? And I'm so glad that each year between seasons, there's a period of trying out. There's a period where we add new members to the team. And that's what we're doing now. Somebody's here today, and you want to play. You want to be on the team. You've tried to condition yourself. And that's good. But when you get on the team, we got a whole nother regiment that's going to help you to be even more conditioned. The Lord needs you. He needs you to go out in the highways and the byways and take the word of God. And so if you're here today and you haven't accepted Christ in the free pardon of your sin, today is your day. The doors of the church are open. We want to extend an invitation to you that you can come. Yes. Is there one today?